Hello everybody, and welcome to my new Let's Play of modded Fallout 3. I've been kind of looking forward to this. I haven't managed to get around to it very quickly because I've been trying to catch up with my Dragon Age and my Oblivion Let's Plays. It's this funny thing when you start rendering, uploading, and you realise how many episodes you have recorded of other things when you're trying to render them, and you can't render them as quickly, you can't load them as quickly. So I finally have the time where I'm finally doing my Fallout 3. Now, for those of you who don't realise, like my Oblivion Let's Play, this will be role-played. And what that means is that my character's going to have a personality, he's going to have his own motivations, he's not going to do things that won't suit his character, he's not going to know things in-game that he wouldn't know. So, without any further ado, let's kick in. Now this game is modded, and I have a variety of mods in. All of these will be in the description below. No, I will not be able to help anyone figure out how to get the mods to work. This music seems different.
This music seems different to usual.
One of the best opening scenes to a game, in my opinion. Sing with me, children!
I don't want to set the world on fire.
She's got it in my head now.
I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my
I always find it weird you can pick those little hula girls up. I don't know why. I just seem to think you should be able to collect them, like you could bobbleheads, and I have no idea why that thought was always in my head.
That one is you.
So, comment below, what is the most useless junk you started collecting in the Wasteland? Because, for me, I think it was Nuka-Cola trucks.
I've lost all ambition.
I just started grabbing them because I was like, ooh, trucks! I don't know why. Oh, and pre-war money, and cigarettes. I never sold them. This is unmodded, but, you know, so I couldn't use the cigarettes. I just started collecting the cigarette cartons, and pre-war money. And eventually I just made a pile of the money on my bed, and I slept on a pile of money every day. It was kind of fun. In a really narcissistic manner. Wow. Look at that beautiful skyscraper scenery. Stuff. Quick warning and quick spoilers, he's not actually a bad guy. But I remember when the game first came out, and that trailer first came, well, sorry, the trailer first came out, everyone was just like, oh, Lord, who's he? What's he going to do to us? And well, he's so intimidating, and it turned out he's a good guy.
War. War never changes.
Since
the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything, from God to justice, to simple psychotic rage. In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world, but war never changes. In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened. It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters. And no one ever leaves.
What a cheery, heartfelt message for the kids. Oh, I got a bag of cigarettes. Yay! Oh, this'll be all the mods loading up. The librarian along the banks of the Potomac River, not far from Rivet City, a well-maintained triple armor-plated multi-port hammer altering vehicle has mysteriously appeared. Destination Eat East Anacostia. Better check it out. Yes, I'll get right on that after I've finished being a baby. Because yes, you start off in this game as a baby. Oh god, the lights! Where am I? Who are you? Are you God? Are you God? I'm scared.
Are you a boy or a girl?
How would I know? I'm a baby. Like, seriously, there's a lot of ass to a baby. It's like, are you a boy or a girl? Let me check that. Okay, I'm a boy.
It's a boy. A boy. We've got a son, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy baby boy.
Oh, lovely.
Oh, James, we did it. A son. A beautiful son.
Woo-hoo.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, son.
I feel privileged already.
Look at you. Look at you.
Hello to you, too.
Hi there. I'm your daddy, little guy.
No. No, don't be my father. I don't like you.
And I have been talking. What do you think about...
What do you think about... Crexo, because of course that will be his name, because we are Crexo, so our character is going to be called Crexo. I don't even know how I came up with the name Crexo. I came back at it as far back as when I first got my PS3 and I was creating an online name. And I don't know why or how I came up with it.
Fits you perfectly. Looks like they've finished the gene projection.
It fits me perfectly, does it?
Let's see what you'll look like when you're all grown up.
Wah! Wah! Baby Pharaoh wants milk! Fetch me a nipple, as the old Yu-Gi-Oh! Bridge used to say. No, no, no. That's kind of a bit better, but I'd like him... No, no offense, I'd like him just a tiny bit more white. Not because I'm against playing a colored character, but because I am as pale as anything. And my eye color... Oh, that's meant to be blue? I don't know how it looks on your screens, but on my screens, that was like grey, kind of. Oh well, whatever. And hairstyle. Pompadour. Generally, I am not a big fan of the hairstyles in Fallout 3, so I just go with Pompadour, because it looks the least terrible, in my opinion. It doesn't look good, don't get me wrong, but it's like the least terrible option, in my own opinion. But, you know, everyone's going to have their favourites. A lot of people seem to like to go for, like, really proper, full beard, messy hairstyle kind of wasteland look. But I like to think our character is, well-groomed. Likes to keep himself looking good. There's a question. Should I roleplay as something else entirely, or should I go for ginger hair, because I'm ginger? For those of you who don't know, I am ginger. It's a wonderful hair colour. It means, you know, I can't go out and play in the sun with the other children. Because I burn. Yeah, why not? Let's make him ginger for no reason. And as usual, I'm going to leave the face because I've never really got into tweaking like 1,000 different bars to make his eyebrow just slightly raised. Yes, and that my
You're
character.
You're going to look a lot like your dad.
Oh dear God, no.
See that, Catherine?
Oh. Very strapping.
You already have a husband, lady. Do not come on to me. You've had way too much to drink.
Son, full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be?
A terrible one.
Just James?
Catherine?
James?
Catherine! She's in cardiac arrest. Start compressions. Get the baby out of here. Move! Move! 1,000.
She's in cardiac arrest.
Come
That's
on.
A heart attack, right?
Hang on, Catherine.
Am I wrong on that?
Okay? You...
We need a doctor. 1 year later.
Fail to meet my expectations no. And there will be
Don't look straight James into the light now.
I'm hearing voices in my head again.
Just like home. Come on over here, son. Well, come on. Walk to daddy.
I think that kind of got messed out there, but as you saw, he said, don't look at the lights.
And look here, we have Amanda.
Just a little further.
Hey-o!
Hello.
And now we can talk, sort of.
You can do it.
Look, I can jump as well as walk. Can you imagine a one-year-old that can
over
jump
here
up and down on a spot and like, literally just not even climb, just jump onto a chair.
Count
that's like one amazing child. Take Dean's electronics.
Just a little further.
Take Mr. Patches. See this teddy bear? See this teddy bear? It's my teddy bear now.
Come to daddy.
So yes, that's a mod to have a sister with you called Amanda.
You can do it.
Yes, yes, I'm here.
There you go.
What do you want?
My
I was very
goodness,
busy playing with
a
teddy bear.
Just a year old and already walking like a pro.
I can jump,
Your
too.
Your mother would have been so proud.
Oh, don't get on
Listen,
the booze again.
I know you don't like it when daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You just stay here while daddy runs to his office. You'll be okay, pal. I'll be back in a bit.
Oh, no. I've seen this movie. It was terrible. It was called Home Alone, and two burglars broke in, and this child, like, went all sore on their collective burglary butts and, you know, tortured them horribly. It was... You think about it, Home Alone's really dark. Wow. No wonder children get really giddy and antsy if this is all their entertainment is. This is terrible. I'm busting out of here. Yeah, ball, you go roll off. Open the playpen's gate. And yes, I already know how to jump. And now this is my teddy. This is my teddy. Woohoo! I have superpowers! I am Mr. Super Teddy. Where'd my teddy go? Where'd my teddy go? Oh, you... He's gone to sit in the naughty corner because he's been very bad. Come on, Mr. Teddy. You're coming with me. I haven't been through playing with you yet. Now let's read the book. You're special! Because, you know, what child doesn't want to be called their special? I can't be going through all these. I just edit them at the end. It's much easier. Right, let's see. Our character is going to be generally pretty intelligent. He's got to be charismatic. Fairly charismatic. He's not going to be like a, you know, someone who can talk anyone out of any piece of clothing ever. But he's going to be fairly, you know, intelligent. Strength up 1, I think, and luck up 1. Now, this is a very bland kind of mix, because everything's 5 to 7s. However, I will be altering this later with the use of bobbleheads and perks. So, you know, it will get a lot better than that, I assure you. It's simply, I usually take off perception if I take off anything, but I don't really want to do that just at the moment, because having perception early on game can be very useful when, you know, massive monsters are around every corner. Look at the Your Special book. Yay. I feel so much better. Die, Teddy. You have betrayed me for the last time. Where are the others? What are the rebels planning? Damn you, how do you keep your silence? Hi, Dad. I was just playing.
You are quite the little explorer, aren't you?
Do you want
to
play?
Right for trying to
it's your turn to interrogate him.
Come on over here. I want to
That's
show
it.
You
Kick
something.
Him. Kick him. Interrogate him.
See that? It was your mother's favorite passage.
Oh, God, you're getting religious, aren't you? Play.
Revelation 21:6.
Play with the teddy.
I am Alpha and Omega.
Just,
the beginning,
you know,
and the end.
Beat him around a bit. It's fun.
I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of
yeah,
life.
Yeah, see this religious sign?
He always
Teddy's beating
her.
It.
All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amada wants to play.
I wonder if Amada will beat up the teddy with me. Come on, Teddy. You're doing your helicopter routine with Amada today. Did he just trip over the teddy? Come on. Daddy, play with the teddy.
Don't be a damn fool. We experiment to prepare. We prepare to survive.
I'm hearing the voices again. Oh, God.
You blinded the poor kid.
Every day I'm
Happy
getting blinded.
Birthday.
Can you believe it? He is growing up so fast.
Yay for me. I'm growing
Happy
up so
birthday,
fast.
Happy birthday, pal. I can't believe you're already 10.
Neither can
I'm
I. It's been like
so
a minute or so.
If only your
Congratulations,
mother.
Young man. I don't have to tell you how special this day
Could
is,
Could you look
do
at
I?
Me, please?
Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well, you're ready to take on your first official vault responsibility.
I'll inspect the women.
So here you are. As overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000. get used to it.
Yay,
you'll
I have
be
a
getting
slave
your
shackle.
First work assignment tomorrow.
That's kind of creepy, but all right.
Enjoy your party.
Happy birthday, little brother.
Whoa. So yes, this is the mod. I believe it's called Ties That Bind. It adds a older sister. A lot of these mods, I play tested them to a certain extent to see if they mostly work, but I've never like completed them. I've never fulfilled them to fruition. So with Amanda, she seems fairly good. You know, she's voice acted and everything else, so that's all right. Aren't you supposed to be grounded?